It's the trooper. Yo, it's like 4:36 p.m. right now. You gotta get your ass out of my way, pal. You can't fucking sit there. So I'm starting the vlog a little bit later today than normal because as soon as I came out of the apartment earlier, I was on a phone call regarding important business that you will all know about really soon, negotiating a deal on a certain thing, and everybody's gonna love it and everybody's gonna be happy. So we'll get to that at another time. This traffic's killing me. This dude in front of me is killing me. Move that Mercury Sable out of my damn way. Thank you. Oh Lord, this dude's trying to die. Yes, I know he's in the bike lane. He's still trying to die. Yo, it's a little after 5 p.m. What's the time? The damn clock is not on the screen when I'm in reverse. That's the second time that happened today. It's 5:19 p.m. I am on my way to the strip now. We're gonna hit up Shake Shack for a burger. What? And then I am going to play poker. And I feel super good today. A lot of things were accomplished today, and I got very, very close to finalizing a situation that you guys are gonna love. Don't talk about it yet. I just feel super motivated. I feel rested. But let me tell you a story real quick on the way to the strip. So I just sort of want to clarify something that I talked about a few videos ago. I think I left a lot of people with the impression that I'm a vlogger who plays poker, not a poker player who vlogs. But really, neither one of those are true. I am a poker player and I am a vlogger. They're two separate things that are intertwined and related to the story. And obviously vlogging is the way the story gets told. I've said it before and I'll say it again. I've gone broke a couple of times, yes. But the first time I went broke in Vegas, let's be honest, I arrived in Vegas with $2,000. The day I got here, I knew I was probably gonna have to get a job. That is a very long shot. I ended up quitting the job and I ended up going broke. And the reason that I went broke was not putting in enough hours, not spending enough time playing poker. You know, back in 2009, I spent 5 months in Cherokee, North Carolina. 20 weeks I spent there. And I was getting free rooms most of the time and a discount, really cheap discount on rooms part of the time. And I won $10,000 during the course of the 20 weeks. Basically $500 a week for 20 weeks. But I went broke. And when I went broke, and I started to analyze the figures, I realized that I was only playing about 15 to 20 hours of poker per week. Because I had live situations that were extremely stressful that I was dealing with, and I had a girlfriend situation, and once or twice a week, I was driving 3.5 hours away from Cherokee and paying for a hotel every time. And then when I was in Cherokee, my mind was just all fucked up. I was not emotionally where I needed to be in order to, you know, play poker for a living. And I didn't put in the work. So I spent myself broke. If you do the math on 20 hours a week for 20 weeks, it's 400 hours at 10K profit. I was making $25 an hour at 1-2. This was a $300 max buy-in and the games were really, really, really good. And I also know that 400 hours is not a large sample size. Whether that was sustainable or not for a really long term, I have no idea. But the point is the games were super good in the backwoods of Cherokee, North Carolina, 2009. Sometime shortly after that, I was having a conversation with my mom and I told her, I was like, you know, my problem is that I don't put enough hours into the game. I don't play enough hours. That is why I went broke. And it's amazing to me that within the last year, I had the same thing happen again. So to sum it all up, basically what I was saying the other day and what I'm saying now is that this story and this journey and this period in my life is me realizing in a different way and fixing that problem about myself. The part of me that procrastinates and put things off and makes excuses for not working. I'm not a vlogger who plays poker and I'm not a poker player who vlogs. I am a poker player and I am a vlogger and I'm going to win at both. I didn't eat anything at Starbucks today. I haven't eaten anything yet, and I'm about to die. Don't even look at me, bitch. Always trying to get me back. One day we're gonna have to try Samba Latte. Not right now, though. It's all about that food right now.
See you.
For some reason, it takes people forever to order at Shake Shack. It's a fucking burger and fries. Order the shit, pay for it, and get out of the way. Yo, Shake Shack and Five Guys are different, but it's getting more and more difficult for me to say which one is my favorite. That shit was unbelievable just now. And the bacon was hot and crispy. Five Guys fries murder Shake Shack fries, but Shake Shack fries are not that bad. I think I'll have a coffee for a few minutes. So I'm gonna let the Shake Shack settle in, sip on this coffee for just a few minutes, and then we're over to Excalibur to start playing poker. So there's some guy playing music over there, and he's letting some girl sing with him, and she's nowhere close to singing on key. It sounds worse than karaoke. You can't see him from here. It's so funny because she's fucking terrible. And she thinks she's good, and she's like improvising and shit. And clearly the guy playing the guitar is just trying to, futilely trying to get some. He's telling her how great that sounded. Oh my lord. I'm gonna fucking hurl my Smoke Shack burger all over this thing. Well, that was a nice little relaxing few minutes of coffee sipping, and now it's time to make my way to a poker room. I'm gonna start at Excalibur tonight, just for the heck of it. Just to do something completely different.
Take my music with you. No light around.
Worst part of Vegas. Worst part. Excalibur is such a dump. Yo, shouts out to the dude that came over and said what up to me when I was playing Excalibur tonight. I was trying to be inconspicuous, so I didn't say much. Sorry about that. I actually just looked around the room for you before I left, to say hi or whatever. But I just saw a sign for the Camelot Steakhouse. I thought that shit said Camel Toe Steakhouse. I was like, what the? So yeah, I decided to go on a little short stacking mission, which I'm still in the middle of. Buying in for 100 at 1-2, not because I have to or not because I'm broke. Don't get ridiculous. I just want to change it up and mix it up a little bit. And when you short stack, you simplify your decision-making process. It's pretty easy to make decisions when you're short. So I played an Excalibur just now. I bought him for 100. Then I just quit $58 ahead. I was gonna go play at Luxor, but now they have no game. So now I'm walking back to Monte Carlo. They actually have 3 1-2 games. Yo, shout out to that guy right there in the blue shirt who just said trooper as he walked by. I barely heard him, and I looked over as he was going that way, and he looked at me and smiled. I guess he said trooper. By the way, I've never played at Monte Carlo ever. This will be the first time tonight. So I just heard Justin Bieber something about go love yourself. And now the very next song is this bitch talking about I love me, I love myself. What the hell's going on? So yeah, I just left the Monte Carlo poker room. My game was breaking, but I won at Monte Carlo as well. So I won at both places. I'm not gonna tell you how much I won. I'll tell you, I won $6. Let me reiterate that I'm not short stacking because I have to or need to. I'm doing it because I just wanted to do something different. Short stacking is actually a fun way to play poker. It's very low stress, and the decision-making process is easier. A lot of it is just automatic. You know what I mean? So that's why I did that tonight. And you know what? I may do it again tomorrow. I don't know. That's the end of another vlog. So let me remind you, from the third floor of the Aria parking garage, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Don't you run over me, motherfucker. Leave a comment below, subscribe so you don't miss anything, and tell your friends about the shit so they can watch it too. I know that was not in the proper and correct order, but it doesn't matter. Because we do what we want to do. I'll see you next time. Had to happen. I almost got an Egg McMuffin at the McDonald's in Monte Carlo. Bitch, please. I'll see you next time.